Hi, today we're going to be looking at the Flashforge Creator Pro 3D printer, and here's a sample of some of the objects that I've printed on this 3D printer. You have this little elephant, you have this heart thing with some cogs, and I'll look at the others in a while. Now there's only a few different 3D printers available here in the Philippines. You have the Flashforge, there's a couple of those models available. You have the Up Mini. You have cdrking's 3D printer, which is kind of overpriced, and it's actually a vellemen that's been rebranded cdrking. And then you have the Puzzlebox, which is a locally made printer, well, kind of locally made, and hopefully I'll actually be going to the Puzzlebox offices sometime soon. I'm just waiting for them to confirm the date, so hopefully I'll also be showing you the Puzzlebox, and we can do a bit of a comparison between the two printers. There are some other printers available locally, but normally it's just one or two used units available, or they say you have to put down a deposit and then wait 2 or 3 weeks. So basically they're going to take your money, order it from China, and then when it arrives they're going to charge you like whatever it costs them plus 10 or 20,000. So let's take a closer look at the printer. You can see the front here, we have the LCD. Now this is really easy to use. You basically just go through the menus and there's not really anything to work out. Inside here we have the SD card that just pops in and out like that, so that's simple enough to use. Now here we have the build plate, and this gets hot, and this is one that you need to keep leveled, so it has to be perfectly level in every direction. So this is where your 3D prints are printed onto. Now up above we have the extruders, and you'll see that we have two here, and that means you can load different filaments into each one. They have fan cooling, of course, because they have to be kept at a fairly stable temperature. So these can move left and right, and they can move back and forth, and of course the base plate, like I said, can only go up or down. And to be honest, that's actually pretty much it. I mean, obviously it's a bit more technical, you've got some stepper motors and a controller board and everything like that, but essentially it's really just plastic that's melting out of there. Like, this will come level with this plate here, and then it will just move back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, building up layer by layer. So let's take a look at the back of the printer. We have the filaments here on the back. They come up through these tubes and then they go through to the extruders at the top here. Now, if you haven't seen a 3D printer in action before, you might find it a little bit difficult to wrap your head around how it actually works. What you have at the back of the printer is the filament, and that's this here. So it comes on a roll. Each roll is 1 kilogram, and you can see in here, that's what it looks like. It's like a 1.75 millimeter. It's kind of like a string, but it's ABS plastic. You can see it comes on rolls like this of around 300 to 400 meters. Now it's actually sold per kilo, so this is a 1 kilogram roll, but that equates to around 300 to 400 meters. So this filament is fed into the extruder. Now the extruder is like the print head on your normal desktop printer that moves back and forth. It basically heats the plastic until it melts, and it can move in the X and the Y, so it will move back and forth creating layers, and the build plate that it prints onto can also move up and down. So it will move back and forth, making one layer of plastic, then the build plate will drop, then it will do the next layer, and it keeps building that up layer by layer until you end up with an object that's a finished 3D print. Now this thing here, I just downloaded this, I didn't design it, but you can see that it's fully working, the cogs move around, and it's got quite a nice finish on it. I'll move it closer to the camera. So you can see these cogs turn. Now this was all printed in one go. I didn't have to snap bits together. This is all one print. So that's pretty impressive. That's just to give an example of what the 3D printer can do. This is another one that was printed in one piece. It's a an elephant. So you can see like that. And it has legs that can move. And its little head can bop around a bit. And it can lay down, it can sit. And again, this was all printed as one piece. This isn't something I've snapped together. This was printed as one piece laying like this, and it was designed so that when it finishes printing, you can pull it off and you end up with a nice finished elephant like this. This here is a dock for your phone. So you use your original cable and you just print the dock and then put the cable in there. I've actually glued that in place, so that's why it looks a little bit shiny. So now when I sit at my desk, I just get my phone, sit it on here, and it starts charging. And this one here is actually my own design. It's a work in progress. It's a little cannon, and it will actually fire using matchstick heads. But that will be in a future video, I'll show you that. Now you might be thinking, doesn't that use a lot of plastic to print something like this? Well, it doesn't, because although these are very strong, they're actually not 100% plastic. There is some hollow space inside. So as an example, I printed this. This was basically a rectangle, half a cube, and I've cut it open to show you what's inside. So you can see that it's like this. I think this is around a 10% infill. So if it was 100%, this would be a solid block of plastic. But with 10%, you have this kind of honeycomb structure. So this was all one solid piece. It's only because I've cut it in half. And it's like this. And it's really strong. Like, if I try and bend this... In fact, I think I cut myself. So yeah, although the plastic, you know, creaked a bit, it didn't break. It's actually my skin that broke before the plastic did. So although you're only printing with a 10% infill, it makes extremely strong pieces, and it saves you from having to waste plastic by, you know, printing this as a whole solid piece. So let's get a little bit more specific about this printer, the Creator Pro. It can print in both ABS and PLA plastic. Now, those are the two main plastics that people use for 3D printing. They both have their pros and cons. The ABS is a bit stronger, but it's not so environmentally friendly. These are printed in ABS plastic. Now, PLA plastic is made from corn and it's biodegradable, so it's, you know, it's much healthier for the world and for the environment. But it has an issue where if you put it in a hot temperature, for instance, if this was printed in PLA plastic and then I put it on my car dashboard and went driving in the sun, it would basically start to melt and it wouldn't look so great. I mean, it can withstand some heat, but it's really not that great compared to ABS plastic. So that's why a lot of people actually prefer printing in ABS. Now, talking about environmentally friendly, let's talk about human friendly. Whether you're printing in PLA plastic or ABS, you pretty much don't want to be in the same room as your printer. Because you're melting plastic, you know, you're heating it up to say 200 degrees, 230 degrees, and you know, that obviously lets off fumes and you could be breathing those in. So although you do see a lot of people on YouTube where they're sitting next to their printer and it's going zug 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 zug, and you know, they're like, I wouldn't recommend it. Basically, keep away from the printer when it's printing. You know, maybe a few minutes exposure just to check on how it's doing, but I certainly wouldn't recommend sitting in the room while this thing is printing. Now, this printer has two extruders, so that means two nozzles that are basically melting the plastic and moving back and forth. Now you might think, great, that means double the speed, right? Well, this nozzle is, or this extruder is working on one part of the design, this one can work on the other. Unfortunately not, because they both share the same rail and they move together. So it can't speed up a print, but what it can do is it can allow you to print in multicolors. So for example, if you were making this heart, you could put blue plastic in one extruder, white in the other, and the bit around the side could be printed in blue plastic, and then the cogs could be printed in the white. Just as an example, you could obviously use different colors. Another thing you can do, depending on the firmware of your printer, is actually print the same object side by side. So you're printing two at a time. One extruder is working on one is working on the other. Now this can obviously work because they're both moving exactly the same locations and they're both tied to each other. The only limitation is that the object cannot be larger than the distance between the two extruders, because otherwise it just wouldn't, you know, it wouldn't be physically possible. Now, if you're wondering why I have the printer sitting here instead of on my desk like everything else that I normally look at, this printer is heavy. If I put this on my desk, in fact, I did put it on the desk, and I was pretty sure the desk was about to fall, so I took it off the desk and moved it here. This is a heavy printer. Now I like that because it means it's sturdy, you know, it's really well built. It has a metal frame and the side panels are wood. The back panel is also wood, but the frame itself is a really heavy metal. Now you'll see the acrylic cover here and this one at the top. This is basically to keep the heat in. When you're printing ABS plastic, you want to try and maintain a constant high temperature. So this acrylic tries to keep the heat in, but they are removable. You see, you can just take this off And you could lift this up. So you can lift up the front here, but there's no way to keep it up. What I've done in the past is I've just put a box here underneath to balance it on. But what I might do is maybe 3D print something that can clip here and just hold it in place. So when I want it open, it will stay open. That's also useful when you're trying to level the printer or when you're trying to clean out the inside, because you have to keep pushing this up. It's kind of a pain. So I'll probably print something that can hold this in place. Now you can hook this up to your computer using a USB cable and you can print like that, but it's not recommended, because what happens if you're printing and then your computer crashes? You're probably going to screw up your print and you're not going to be able to continue, so you might have wasted an hour or 2 hours in printing time. So what they recommend instead is using the SD card. Now it comes with the SD card and some sample files on the SD card. So basically you can prepare your 3D print files on your laptop or your desktop, put them on the SD card, put it into the front, and then you can start printing, and it will print like that without having to be connected to a computer. So that's really the best way to print, and I really like the fact that this printer has that option, because, you know, I've seen some videos on YouTube where people are printing from their computer, they've had the blue screen of death, and then I've just lost my print, I have to start all over again. So, you know, SD card is really a must in my opinion. Now, another useful feature about this printer is it has a heated build plate. Now, what that means is that the area that you're printing onto is actually going to heat up to around 100, 110 degrees Celsius, and that will help the plastic stick to it. That's one of the biggest problems with 3D printers for many people. They can't get their plastic to stick to the base, and if you can't get it to stick, you can't print. So the heated base really helps to make sure that the first, you know, layer or two layers of plastic stick to the base, and then, you know, the rest of your print will just be fine because it'll be printing on top of the other plastic, which it obviously sticks to very well. Now, leveling these printers is the most important thing. The base here that it prints onto, if your base isn't level, you can't print. I can't even explain how much frustration and annoyance and anger and upset leveling this printer will cause you. It is a pain. Basically, if it's not level, everything goes wrong. It will either print and the plastic will be hanging off the top and you'll end up with squiggles everywhere, or it will print and then, because it's out of balance, when it goes to the back and then comes to the front, it will rip off the front section. There's just so many problems that will go wrong if you don't level the base correctly. Now, leveling this thing, it's technically not that difficult. It has three screws underneath, wing nuts that you adjust, and each time you adjust one, it makes a slight adjustment to the plate, moving it, you know, up or down in whatever direction. And you slide a piece of paper between the base and the nozzle, and when there's a little bit of friction, you know it's in the right place. Now, it sounds easy, but I spent so many hours trying to level this because I made a change to something inside, and then I had to re-level it. And it was a nightmare. It took me days. I think I finally worked out the best way of leveling it, so I'm probably going to make a video showing other people how to do that. It might not be the best way, but for me it worked and I was able to level it, but it took me a long time to really actually work out a way of doing it that worked for me. Now, this printer came from Zhaidazz 3D printers, and I put their contact details in the video description below. Now, I recommend them for a few reasons. One, they're the cheapest price in the Philippines, so that's already a good, you know, starting point. Two, they include free delivery and setup, and the setup is a big thing, trust me. When they say, do you want me to set it up, you say yes, 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 you want them to set it up. And also they include a bunch of freebies, and you know, they're really good with support. I messaged them, you know, I've had like the leveling issues I mentioned, they really helped me through that, so you know, I do recommend them. So I hope you enjoyed the video. There's probably gonna be a lot more 3D printing videos to come. Probably whenever I print something, I'm going to show it printing and then I'll show the finished thing, because there's, you know, a million things I want to print and that I want to design and print. So you're probably gonna see a lot of 3D printer videos on my channel, so I hope you like them. If you have any questions, put them in the comments section as always. And why don't you tell me what you would print, or, you know, what you would design? You know, sometimes I can't even sleep because I'm thinking, oh, I could print that, I could print that. Or I remember projects I wanted to do in the past, and then, you know, I thought, oh, how would I do that? Because I would have to make a mold and then, you know, carve it, and it would be very difficult. And then I think, oh, I could 3D print that, I could design it and 3D print it. And I just sit there for hours thinking of things I could print. So I'd love to hear what you would print, or recommendations, or things that you want to see me print. Please remember to give a thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already.